it's the first day of the month, and that means that the new job numbers are out. Economists did predict better numbers than last month, and that's what we got. 224,000 jobs created in the month of June. Here to break it all down, we have Doug Butler from Rockland Trust. Thanks so much for being with us this morning.
Sure. Thanks a lot, Joe.
Okay, so we want to start by just kind of laying out the numbers when it comes to unemployment, because you're saying on their face they could be deceptive. 3.7% increase in unemployment.
Yep, so that's up 0.1% from last month. But the good news here is more people joined the labor force. So it was, you know, more people are looking for work, so more less people are discouraged, less people are, you know, worried about not being part of the growth of the economy. Mm-hmm. So that tick up really represents the fact that more people are looking versus bad news for the economy.
Mm. Okay, and also looking at kind of what the markets have been doing, and you know, basically the high has kind of been reached and it's coming down a little bit now. So what are your thoughts though on what's gonna happen from here? Are we gonna get more growth? Are we fearing recession?
We're not afraid of a recession at all for this year, for 2019. It's very unlikely even one comes in the first part of 2020. The Fed will likely cut rates in July, but this number has really made it so that the Fed will not likely cut three times, which is what the market had been forecasting before this blowout number. And that's what you're seeing, why you're seeing a bit of a sell-off today.
Okay, okay. You know, of course, a lot of questions, a lot of talk about the ongoing trade war. And in your opinion, how do these latest numbers impact the trade war, if at all?
They shouldn't impact it too much. I mean, I think the president gives the president a little more room in terms of having a strong economy, even with trade sanctions in place, gives him a little more room to delay implementing trade negotiations with China or sort of giving in too quickly. He has, you know, he probably has the rest of the year to figure out a deal.
Okay. Okay, and then as we look at what's happening for the rest of the year, and you know, I mean, of course, we're always concerned about the long-term forecast. You're saying that we're probably not going to see any significant slowdown for the rest of the year, possibly into next year.
Not from the economy. You shouldn't, you know, the markets may sell off a little more here or there, but really the economy is doing really well. I mean, we've averaged about 170,000 jobs these last 3 months, which is a good number. It like allows the economy to continue to grow at a reasonable pace.
Okay, well, thank you so much for joining us, Doug Butler from Rockland Trust. Caitlin, back to you.